Hello, and welcome to the next part. Today I'll be taking the two chains that I created using the warping mill, and I'm going to put them on one of my looms. The loom that I'm using is my Baby Wolf loom. It happens to be a 4-shaft loom. I'll show you how I take the chains and start the process of warping from back to front. All right, we're going to take a little tour. Here's the two chains. They are draped over the front part of the beam and they go through over top of the beater. As you can tell, I took the reed out and they're going through. We're going to go along to the other side and we can see that they are draped through, and at the moment they are just kind of draped over that back beam there. I also have the rattle ready. And I have my two rods that are connected at the bobbin, and I'll explain how that works shortly. I do have a protector on top of my rattle for the moment. I will be taking that off, but I'll show you one of the ways that I happen to use that on the top, and then I will remove it. All right, I have everything set up. I now have my warping helpers. These are what I use to attach my leaf sticks rather than cords, and I'm going to take you to the back and show you that if you do have a loom this size, these actually will attach to the front beam and all the way to the back beam. So I have two sets ready to start using. Sometimes I do hang them from the castle, which I probably will change over after a while, but to set up, I'm going to keep them where they are, and I'm going to come over here and explain the steps that I use. What I like to do is I have two leaf sticks here and they have holes in them. And this particular handy gadget happens to have a machine screw and a grommet. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the first stick and I'm going to, I already have my, like I said, I have my warps ready to go. Here, I'm going to put it through the cross on the one and the cross on the other side on the other one. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to take the machine screw, put it through there and snap it in. If you don't have this device, then you would need to do your tying how you normally do for your other, you know, whatever shoelaces, whatever cords you have, whatever you use. And I have the same thing on the other side, another machine screw. I'm gonna pop that in. And again, it goes through the grommet on the other side. And I snap that in. Now, I'm on the other side of the cross that I did. And the other side. So what I'm going to do next is I will take the other stick, place that through on both the chains. And again, I will take the machine screw through there, put it through the grommet, pop it in. And do the same thing on the other side. And pop it in and through, and now the cross is secure. If I push those there, you see the two crosses. The ties are still in there, though. I'm not going to take those out yet. Now, the next thing I have is I have the extension. You know, I have the two rods. I have the one rod with the cords on. Some people have aprons. And what I've done is I've made sure that these two cords are exactly the same length. I'm actually recycling the cord from the tie-ups for this particular loom. And I have them on each end. But what I want to do now is I need to take the end and insert it over this. So right now what I'm going to do is I have this cord. I'm going to make this a little bit longer, release the brake. I'm going to bring it up over the side here, then it makes that this won't fall back and on the ground. So sometimes you feel like all thumbs. What I'll do then is I'm going to take the one end off and I'm going to loop this through here. Now this is where I had one little extra end that didn't loop around. So I just have a little overhand knot and I'm going to slide that one on there. Normally that doesn't always happen, but that's what happened with this particular warp. And I slip the other one through the other end. Now, what I need to do, this is where sometimes it's a little bit difficult to do. This one, I basically loop it around because I want it to be fairly secure. So now I'm going to take the end of the rod, I'm going to put that in there. Now this is basically ready for me to start taking all the ties off and the cords off, and then I will show you how I adjust everything to fit into the rattle next. All right, now it's time to start taking some of the ties off, and I feel pretty good that the leaf sticks are secure. So the first thing I'll do is we'll take the tie out that's in the cross, the one cross, and I need to do the other one. Remember, I have two. So I have that ready. Now the next thing I want to do is take these off. If you notice on this one, I only had the the one tie. Guess I got a little lazy on that. I got that one out. I have the one that was on the top and the bottom. And I'm untying those. Now I noticed just now too that I have one loose loop thread here, because when I started this one, I had another thread. So what happened here, get that around so you can see, I actually have another loop here. So what I need to do now is I need to take this off and slide this one on and then put this back on. I'll do another little loop on there so you get to see what I did the last time, put that back on. Again, that's what happens if you have an odd number, if you're warping. So right now I have that so far set up. Next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to take these ties off. And this one. All of these have been keeping the yarn nice and tidy, is what I like to say. Kind of keeping it together, because you are moving it from your warping mill or your warping board to the loom. And by keeping everything fairly nice and organized, it helps. So if we look here, okay, there we have the crosses going on, but still everything back here, still a little kind of bunched up. The next thing I'd like to do is I like to spread it out and maybe separate. And in this case, I can probably go down to the cross and separate all the different colors I have. So that's the next thing I'll do. I kind of spread them out. My plan is to at least get this to approximately 16 inches, because that's what we have here. We have an 8 here and we have 8 here. So again, I'm spreading it out. And this, in this situation, it's nice because you have the colors and you can really kind of see. I'm going to do the one half right now. So now we can see I have these kind of loose, spread out. They're starting to spread out, because what I'm going to do then is I'm going to take this over the rattle, keeping the wood on first, and then take the wood off and then start separating them into the each inch segments. And I'll do the same thing on the other side or the other chain. So if you have a couple of chains, you can do several of them and put them all on, or maybe you only have one. So again, right now, because these are different colors, it makes it a little bit easier to separate them. But again, the idea is try to keep them from getting too tangled up. So now I have that ready. Now if you see these ties, this is where I changed the color on the one end. So I just want to kind of bring that to your attention. All right, so we're going to move on to the next phase. All right, now my plan is to take these metal rods and I'm going to start to crank the back beam. And what I want to do is I want to get this just over the edge. I'm going to crank a little bit more to release the brake here. Crank that around. That's close to about there. I'm gonna hold that in that place for the moment, the time beings, because I wanna go on to the another part that I did earlier. Then you can see, hopefully you can see here, these were the groups I had. These are inches here. I also have the same thing on this one. Now these inches and groups are gonna help me when I take the top off to help me place them into the inch segments that are underneath that piece of wood. Okay, now I'm ready to take this off and it's all gonna kind of drop into all sorts of spots here. However, the yarn is already spread out a little bit. And now this is where these little groupings come in handy. I've already determined if I start off from the middle of this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, this is where I want my first inch to go. And like I said, I grouped this earlier. I'm gonna take that out. I'm gonna take the first inch and put it in that slot there. And I untied that. Now I'm gonna do the next one, spread that out, take that inch and put that in the next one. So you can see where that's coming. You can keep them tied. However, they'll start to spread out a lot easier if you loosen them up a little bit. So you don't want too tight. So again, I'm spreading them out. Here's the next one, the next group. So if you don't have this nice color striping, you do have them grouped in inches. I'm gonna do the next one. And then the next one. And it almost looks like the next two kind of just about fell into the slot where I wanted them to. So right now, this down here is a little loose, so I'm gonna crank it up a little bit just to tighten it so. There we go. Now I have the first half done. I just need to do the second half. All right, I want to show you what it looks like, and actually I already did a little grooming is what I'll say. All of these came down, but what I did was I went and I kind of spread these out. Now again, with the color is very helpful. I can kind of check it out and kind of, the idea is to have these pretty much spread out. Because what's gonna happen, I'm gonna start winding this on to this back beam. Now I'm just gonna do a couple of turns because I have to stop then and add something. So I'm just gonna turn this basically until it starts right about there. So now it's time for me to add either some cardboard, corrugated cardboard, a roll under here, or some heavy paper. I'm going to relocate the camera so you can see what happens next.